Hello everyone, this is Siddhant Ray here. I'm a grade 9 student from Mumbai in India. I study in Jamnabai Narsee International School. Like many other kids of my generation, I am also an AI, ML and coding enthusiast. I have done many different certification courses on IOT, robotics and web designing from SP Robotics, Bolt IOT and Udemy. I got into the world of coding, AI and ML when I was in grade 6. Since then, I have been pursuing these areas along with my studies. I love to explore and experiment with coding, robotics and IOT. I have completed several small projects on these subjects in the last 3 years. As a 13-year-old, I love the world of coding, robotics and IoT and seek to make a professional future in this area. The goal of my YouTube channel is to share knowledge around robotics, IoT and coding amongst the children of my age and also guide them on what all they should do to get into these areas. Today I shall speak about IoT and share a small project that I have done around it. IoT, or basically Internet of Things, it is a system of interrelated computing devices, mechanical, digital machines, objects, animals or people that are provided with unique identifiers, UIDs and the ability to transfer data over a network without requiring a human-to-human or a human-to-computer interaction. A thing in the Internet of Things can be a person with a heart monitor implant, a farm animal with a biochip transponder, an automobile that has built-in sensors to alert the driver when tire pressure is low, or any other natural or man-made object that can be assigned an internet protocol address or an IP address and is able to transfer data over a network. Increasingly, organizations in a variety of industries are using IoT to operate more efficiently, better understand customers, to deliver enhanced customer service, improve decision making and increase the value of business. Confused? No worries. Let me make things simple for you. Alexa is an example of IoT. Siri and Google Voice Assistant are some other examples of IoT. So now, I presume you understood what IoT is. Next question. How do you set up an IoT platform? The easiest way to do it is by using what is known as a Raspberry Pi. Raspberry Pi is a mini processor, almost as good as a laptop or a computer. Like we use different operating systems on our laptops such as Windows 10, there are different operating systems for Raspberry Pi 2 like Debian Buster, Ubuntu Desktop, RetroPie, etc. However, I am using the official operating system of Raspberry Pi. So here is my Raspberry Pi setup. This is my Raspberry Pi assembly. I've purchased it from Amazon. The link for purchasing this setup is provided in the description box of this video. This is a P-Box India 8GB Raspberry Pi 4 model with a B4B SBC IoT board and Broadcom 1.5 GHz A72 processor with 8GB DDR4 and 4K video. This device has a dual micro HDMI gigabit network and is a 2020 model. This is a do-it-yourself kit, so assembling the Raspberry Pi should not be a tough job for you in case you follow the instructions in the manual methodically. A tip that I can give you is try using a desktop screen, which as in a monitor screen instead of a TV screen, to connect the Raspberry Pi. A 40-inch TV screen may be a bit cumbersome to manage, especially if you are a first timer. If you face any difficulties in the initial hardware assembly or installation of the operating system, just look for some quick solutions on Google or YouTube. Trust me, the setup is pretty simple and should not take you more than 20 minutes. Once the assembly is done and the OS is installed, this is how your Raspberry Pi system shall look like on the screen. I do not have a desktop as in a monitor at home, and hence I have used my TV screen to program through my Raspberry Pi. The first project I did with my new Raspberry Pi setup is a basic calculator. Let me explain my calculator in brief here. I have inserted 6 functions into my calculator. They are addition, subtraction, division, multiplication, square root and percentage. Let me show you some calculations here with my calculator. So we need to click on F5 firstly to run the program. So over here, as you can see, they have given us 6 options to choose. So I'll go with number 1 for addition. So I clicked on 1 and I clicked on enter. So now they have given us blank. So for entering the first number, we'll enter the first number as 3. Now click on enter. Now we'll enter the second number as 4. So now we'll have to again click on enter and we'll get the answer as 7. So now let us carry out some subtraction. So let's click on F5 once again. Now let us enter 2 since we come to carry out subtraction. So let's enter the first number as 25 and let us enter the second number as 20. So as you can see, the output has come to F5, which means it is the correct answer. So now let us try some multiplication. So we'll click on F5, we'll choose option 3, then we'll choose the first number as 20, second number as maybe 6, then we'll click on enter. Then as you can see, the answer has come to 120. Now let us try out some division. So let us take a big number. Let's take 400 as the first one, and we'll take 100 as the second one. So as you can see, the answer which has come is 4, which is the correct answer. So now let us find the square root of a number. Let's click on F5. Now let us click on F5 to run the program once again. Now select option 5 since we want to find the square root. So let's take a big number once again. So for square root, let's take the number 441. So as you can see, there's only one blank since there cannot be two numbers whose square root you can find at the same time. So as you can see, the answer which has come is 21, which is the correct answer. Now let us find the percentage lastly. So in percentage, you'll be given two options. One, the percentage, and secondly, the number whose percentage you want to find. So for example, if I want to find 40% of 200, we'll put 40 in the first blank and 200 in the second blank. So let's see what is the answer. As you can see, the answer has come as 80, which is the correct answer once again. So this was the basic functioning of my calculator. Let me now show you the code for this calculator. I have been a student of IoT and have prior programming experience in Python, so I could write these codes by myself. For beginners in Python and IoT, you could search on Google or YouTube for quick tutorials. As a beginner, you should seek help of Google and YouTube in your first few projects. Parallelly, try to understand and absorb the syntax of the codes you learn from the internet. Slowly and steadily, start writing your own short codes. Wherever you get stuck, see support of Google. Also, try reading books on basic Python coding. I follow this one book. The Amazon link to this book is provided in the description box of this video. As a kid of this generation, you ought to develop interest in coding, and the best way to master coding is to explore it yourself. IoT is a very interesting arena to explore. Today, Raspberry Pi is one of the cheapest processors you'll find online. However, the windows it opens to coding are infinite. So, when are you making your personal assistant like Siri or Alexa on your own? Come on, go and get your own Raspberry Pi today. Start programming and I'm sure you shall love it. Very soon, I shall come up with my next project using Raspberry Pi. Watch out my channel for more videos like this. Please do like this video. Leave your comment in the comment section. Subscribe to my YouTube channel and click the bell icon for many more interesting videos on IoT, AI, ML, coding and web designing. See you soon everyone. Bye for now.